city. He thinks he's worked out all the issues that were technical in nature, having to do with spine materials and all those kinds of things. We've got the provision which says that if we have a disaster, that they're not going to count that as a delay in the project. So that gives us the freedom we need to fulfill our responsibilities if we have a bad problem. And this is the last remaining issue that I'm aware of.
Haven't we worked on many projects for the city before and never had a problem, and this has never come up? Is there some reason that they all of a sudden want
They're following a private contract model. That's the whole issue here. We just need to go back to them again and say, this is not the way we work with the city. That's what we're doing.
And I think that's the part of the resolution. I don't think we ought to. We won't do this very often, and I think that we've got plenty of coverage, and they've got coverage as well. And I just think it's just one of those things that, because they want to go to a contract, you pay the, I don't know how many people we pay. We've done all kinds of work and never had a contract. You have the one page.
Yeah, we pay streets for the city.
Yeah.
No, we just go there and
do it. So I don't know what makes this project different, except PDA has something to do with it as opposed to directly having the city involved in it. The PDA is a quasi-governmental entity.
That's the only thing that's holding us back.
As far as I know, that's the only thing that's holding up. I mean, there were a couple of issues that we had hit on, like water monitoring and things like that. I think they've agreed that they would take care of the water monitoring costs.
I'm like Mike, I think just tell them we're a county entity, take it like it is.
Okay. And we giving them a final price on doing the job?
We gave them a final price, but I think we had to modify that price a little bit based upon what they say is in the contract. I think we put it off the sheet, and after everything was said and done, they were in contract. Few items that weren't on the sheet. I think they'll make work those out. Mm-hmm.
From the tone of the night, I got a question though. Board?
I'd say, my opinion would be just let the county attorney go back to him and tell him exactly what he's doing.
I'll do it.
We need that maybe in a motion or anything?
It's just something that we've been working on for a while, and I just want to go over it.
I think if there needs to be any further discussion with it, also, Mr. Chairman, we have a joint meeting with him scheduled here for the
meeting.
And we'll just put it on the agenda there if this doesn't seem to solve the problem.
Okay. Mr. Chairman?
That's all I have.
Okay.
The status of our junkyard case is that it has been appealed. I talked to David Hutchins last week, and he's received the appeal, but he hasn't received the record yet. And my intention, as soon as the record is received, that I'll try to put it on to a final resolution as soon as I possibly
can.
I don't remember the date, but I saw the photographs and I've seen the. I think we're going to be reasonable on that one as well.
What's the status on the other guy on the road in front of whom live on?
Which one?
I can't remember his name. Mark. This guy's name is supposed to be moving.
Oh, he's moving now.
Mr. Brown.
I don't have a report from personnel, but I would like to make some comments.
and went back and kind of leave them. I just wanted to pass a thank you for that.
Do it again. Mr. Green.
Yes, we, on your January calendar, you have a public property meeting scheduled for January 8th. I'd like to change that to January 15th in order to give Tony a little bit more time to establish the cost of the parking lot at the Hancock Center, and also because some of our commissioners are going to be out of town today. So put on the calendar, the public property meeting will be at 8:30 a.m. on January 15th.
15th?
Pardon?
15th?
15th, yes. And I would like to also echo what Mr. Brown said about the employees and the staff. And just let them know that I do appreciate the hard work that they devote to this county each and every day.
Hey, Mr. Green, this is an easy one.
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman, we do have a few items here that we need to vote on. In the purchase meeting, we have some recommendations. Actually, there's three of them, they're in the packet. The first one is, if I can make a recommendation, motion that we accept IC Solutions, Advanced Technology, as the inmate telephone service. They were the low bidder on that. Years here, if anybody's got any questions about that, I think everyone may have been in the meeting when we looked at these bids that came in. So if there's no discussion on it, I'd like to make a motion that we accept that.
Sir.
Got a motion by Mr. Deason, second by Commissioner Hickey. You got it? All in favor, let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
And opposite?
The second item is the merciful sewage and grinder pumps to solve the problem that we've been having for some time now out of the prison, and we've taken bids on that. And that is also in your packet. AAG Electric Motors and Pumps Incorporated was the low bidder. We had a bid of $13,330.12 for one pump, and inclusive of that was the installation of that pump and the second pump. And then you will see that the second pump alone was $6,120. So for the two pumps and the total installation, make a motion that we accept AAG Electric Motors bid for this of $10,450.12.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Baker. Any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Okay.
And then the final item, Mr. Chairman, is our annual tool bid. And this bid is good for throughout the whole year of 2015. And Whitehead Hardware, Tom Horn Supply, and Holly Incorporated are three different companies. Tom Horn Supply being a local company, have bid on all the list of items. It's quite extensive, it's in your packet. But what we're doing is making a motion that we accept the low bidder for each of those items throughout the year. So you might like to make that motion that the lowest bidder for the item, whether it be Whitehead, Tom Horn, or Holly, the bidder for that tool.
Do I have a second on that motion?
Second.
Second by Mrs. May. All in favor, let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay.
And that's all we have from the purchase committee. We will not have a scheduled meeting the first Tuesday in January. At this time, we don't have anything before us to come up for that meeting. So if some items come in that need to be on the agenda, we'll schedule that and let you know. And also, I'd like to give my thanks to the county staff throughout the whole county for all the hard work that they've done this year. Stayed very close within budget. I'm impressed with a little bit that we are outside of budget, and thank everyone and all departments for that.
Thank you, Mr. Neesman.
February, and my friend is dying. Oh.
Thank you.
When is the tax side ready?
Bill and Magnus will be finished with their part of the project this week. That's all the law street. They paved a lot yesterday out there.
They
paved yesterday, so.
I got the compactor over it.
Compactor's not there, but the compactor people was there last week getting their pile measures and everything. It's up there for it. So, and then the fence has got to put up. And I think we've already got a contract lined up.
I guess you're not a cop figure, I'll give you.
Not just we sometimes.
Good thing, do you have anything?
No, sir, I'd just like to reiterate what the rest of the commissioners said about how, appreciate all the work that everybody's done, and staying in the budgets and doing a good job. Thank you, Mayor Crew.
Mr. Baker.
Hey, I'd love to wish this, the commissioners and their family, and the ones that are attending our meeting, very Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. And hope that you have a safe holiday. And I've enjoyed working with each and every one of you throughout the last 12 months. And I'm looking forward to the 12 months that lies ahead. I know we got a lot of ups and downs, we got a lot of things that got to be fixed, that need to be fixed. So I'm gonna try to enjoy the holiday by relaxing and getting ready for 2015.
Thanks, sir. Commissioner Mayor.
Well, you know, in the last one around here, everything's probably been said, but I think we've had a great year. Of course, I'm very prejudiced. I think we have a great county manager. I think he does a very, very good job. Keeps us out of trouble. Sometimes we butt heads, but all in all, I think this commission works together so well. And you know, contrary to what a lot of people think, we do work well with the city. We have different opinions. They have a lot more money, but I think all in all, whenever there are projects to be done, that we do them as quickly as we can. And I appreciate all the people that come to our meetings. A couple of you are here just about every meeting, and we certainly appreciate your attendance. And so I hope everybody has a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Be safe.
Thank you, Ms. Lee. Nothing else for me to say, but echo what everybody else said. And as everyone said, I just want to thank y'all and for keeping us going. And thank the board. I've been here pretty good while. This is probably one of the better boards that I've worked with since I've been here. So we want to thank you.
Oh, no.
And me, 21 years.
I was going to say one other thing.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, the person who is on our staff that got recognition as being clerk of the year, but sometimes we don't always appreciate everything that Twink does. But I'll tell you, she really does a great job, and she keeps all of us in line, keeps us on tap, and I appreciate Twink very, very much. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
I appreciate her the treasure of the year. She's good.
I did nothing else.